3. Earth relations to the cosmos. We are living in accelerated times. Remember in lesson 1 I said time is speeding up? Let's talk more about that. The following is a fact according to Encyclopedia Britannica. From the time of our oldest known civilization, the ancient Sumerians, around 3800 BC, continuing for almost 6,000 years up to about 1900, a certain number of information was collected. Let's say for simplicity's sake, that in that time we learned one bag of facts. 50 years later, from 1900 to 1950, our knowledge doubled. That means it took 6,000 years to get a bag of facts, and in 50 years, we got another one. Amazing! But then in the next 20 years, we doubled it again. And then in 10 years, we doubled that. And now we're getting bags of facts every month, maybe within days, I don't even know. The fact is, things are speeding up monumentally. We're living within a knowledge avalanche. Life on this planet is accelerating faster and faster, obviously culminating in something new and something different, perhaps just out of the reach of our normal imagination. What does this mean for the world? Why is it happening? Better yet, why is it happening now? Why didn't it happen 1,000 years ago? Or why didn't it wait to happen 100 or 1,000 or 10,000 years from now? It's really important to understand the answer to this question, because if you don't know why this is happening now, then you'll probably not understand what's happening to you in your life, or be prepared for the coming changes. Now, the Earth actually has a wobble. Well, it has many wobbles, but the one I'd like to talk about today is the one called the precession of the equinox. Essentially, what this is a rotation that the planet does, which completes a cycle once every 26,000 years. It looks like this, and slowly turns on its axis, and points to different locations. Science looks at this and says, well, so what? It's just a wobble. But by looking at what the ancient civilizations knew, you see a more complete image. The point actually points to, and away from, the center of the galaxy. The center of the galaxy is where most of the energy, and the most consciousness, is. It's not just light up there, you know? So, in this diagram is our rotation. Here is the tip pointing towards the center of the galaxy, and here is the farthest pointing away. The ancient Sanskrit writings that also talks about this precession call this going with the galactic wind. The Sanskrit writings say that there are two very important places on this wobble. One is at A, and one is at C. Not the very tips, as you might think. There are also important places at D and B, but not as important as A and C. According to these ancient writings, as we hit position A, we begin waking up. And as we hit position C, we begin to fall asleep. We continue on the cycle, but every time we make a full rotation, we wake up more and more. It works the exact same way as day and night on Earth. You go through this cycle every day, waking and sleeping. But every day, you become a little more conscious. You learn new things, you don't do the same things over and over. I want to talk about religion for a bit, because you can definitely see this wobble over recorded human history. See, when we were the ancient Egyptians, Sumerians, and Mayans and such, we were incredibly wise. We may not have known all of the advanced intricacies of the world that we do now, but we knew about the precession of the equinox, and we had an advanced geometric understanding of the universe that we're going to talk about soon. Then we got dumber and became all philosophical, not quite knowing anymore, but still able to understand many things. This is where things like the Fibonacci sequence and pi and the golden ratio were discovered. And then we got dumber still, and it was around this time that we had a real solid formation of most of today's religions. But you have to remember that these religions were based on earlier writings. They were written by people who understood far more than they did. They just couldn't make sense of it, and that's why many Bible stories just seem ridiculous. Ultimately though, every religion did spawn from a more conscious understanding, so you can't discredit religions completely. You just have to trace them back a bit further. You'll also see looking back that we went from a more female-oriented understanding to an incredibly male way of looking at things, very strict and orderly. Not much room for creative thought, it has to be 100% logic-oriented. Back to precession. The Tibetans and Hindus also had these time periods called yugas, which were simply ages. Each yuga had a descending and ascending phase. Many of those who follow New Age beliefs will tell you that we're moving into the Age of Aquarius, but not many people know what that means. Well, we're right here on the precession of the equinox, just about at point A. Remember, this is a really important time for us, not just humans, but all of Earth, and perhaps maybe our solar system. This is a chart showing the precession scale with our constellations. The astronomical sign that we see in the sky when we hit point A will be that of Aquarius. Are you ready for this, the big finisher? Can you guess when we're going to hit point A exactly? The Mayans figured it out. Yep.